Now, such kind of problems would be solved by assuming cases. So, the first case what I am assuming is, let's say x is greater than or equal to 0. Now, when x is greater than or equal to 0, the quadratic equation would be x square minus 3x minus 2 equal to 0. Now, if you calculate the root, so x would be, that's comparing with the standard equation ax square plus bx plus c, x will come out to be minus b, which is minus minus 3 plus minus under root of b square, so that is minus 3 whole square minus 4ac, the 4 into 1 into minus 2. So this is going, and this divided by 2a, so which is 2 into 1. Now this will give you 3 plus minus under root of, will become 9 plus 8, that is 17, divided by 2. Now x has to be a positive number, so one root which I can take is 3 plus root 17 by 2. And if you look, the other root, that is 3 minus root 17 by 2, has to be discarded because x has to be a positive number, and this value will come out to be negative. So one value which the x can take is 3 plus root 17 by 2. So this is one case. Now similarly, you will solve for the other case when x becomes less than 0. So my quadratic would look like x square plus 3x minus 2 equal to 0. So the roots, if I calculate, will come out to be x is equal to minus 3 plus minus under root of 3 square minus 4 into 1 into minus 2 whole divided by 2 into 1. So we calculate the value of x, which will come out to be minus 3 plus minus root 17 by 2. So x has to be a negative number. So the value of x, which I can assume, is minus 3 minus root 17 by 2. So these are the two values of x which are possible for this equation. Now the question is the sum. Now when I am going to do the addition of this, the value will come out to be 0. So the correct answer is option C.